Addressing media in today's weekly security briefing, the police chief political commissar Hadija Namutebi noted that they are registering an increase in cases related to organized crimes, especially robberies. Among these crimes is one in which Wan Lei Chong, a Chinese national who was traveling on a border, was surrounded by a group of four other border around Martin Road in Kampala, and a bag containing 200 million shillings robbed from him. Efforts to apprehend the criminals were futile.
The border from his home in Kololo, and it is suspected that the same rider was on surveillance and he tipped his gang. The police have arrested one of the suspects from Kisenyi, and upon search of his home, we recovered $3,700 and Uganda shillings, 1,900,000 shillings, and the hunt for the accomplices continue.
After the robbery, an operation was conducted in several places, including Bulenga and Fort Portal City, where three suspects were arrested and five motorcycles recovered.
These motorcycles were used in the robbery, and three of the motorcycles were bought from the proceeds of the crime. 5 million Uganda shillings was recovered, and the investigations are still going on.
In a second incident, a group of border riders targeted Hei Wei, a Chinese national who was moving with $190,000 on a border and was surrounded by border riders along Seziwa Road in Nakasero near Fang Fang Restaurant. According to Namutebi, the Chinese had hired a border rider to take him from home, but as they rode around 1 p.m. at Seziwa Road, the motorcycle was intercepted by a group of other border riders and the bag containing the cash was robbed.
Victim had used the border from his home in Kololo, and it is suspected that the same rider was on surveillance and he tipped his gang.
In other news, police have vowed to implement the eviction order of Vebalaro from northern Uganda come Saturday 25th November. The Vebalaro pastorists were given up to November 25th, 2023 to vacate Acholi and Lango regions where they had migrated in search of pastures for their animals.
All those who have not yet complied with the guidelines given after the expiry of the grace period, the implementation will begin.
From the Directorate of Traffic and Road Safety, a total of 390 road crashes were registered last week, and these claimed lives of 73 people, while over 200 were seriously injured. These crashes have been attributed to reckless driving. Motorists have been urged to follow traffic guidelines and laws while on the road.
We shall also strengthen operations on speeding using the already deployed speed guns and CCTV cameras.
And from the Uganda National Examinations Board, UNEB, an update on the ongoing USCE exams was given. Several people have been apprehended for taking part in exam malpractice. These will be prosecuted as per the UNEB Act.
All, we've had a total of 25 cases pertaining to malpractice, both at UCE and PLE, which have been reported to police.
Rachel Nachuala, reporting for the news.